praise the Lord. 2011, this year, I resolve
to love Him.
And who is Him?
Jesus Christ.
Amen. Throughout this year, we have been celebrating and studying the works of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
And as we study, we learned about the fellowship of His suffering. We learned about trying to set an example.
Correct.
We learned about the power of His resurrection.
Wow. Come on now.
We want to know Him.
Yes, sir.
Throughout this month, we've been talking about the discipline of live as we do. Jesus, or Paul, said, Philippians chapter 3, 17, join us in following my example, brothers and sisters. And just as you have us as a model, keep your eyes on those who live as we do. Keep your eyes on those who live as we do.
Amen. Amen.
And throughout this month, we've been looking at the models of the Christian faith. We've looked at the model of a soldier, the model of an athlete, runner. We looked at the model of a farmer. And this morning, we're going to share a message entitled The Ultimate Birth for the Ultimate Sacrifice. As we look at Luke chapter 2, we're going to look at this morning in your hearing verses 1 through 12. Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. Would you please stand in reverence to the word of God? Stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the word of God.
Amen.
Say to your neighbor,
neighbor.
I'm going to stand on the word of God.
On the word of God.
Let's read this out loud together on three. One, two, three.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that
Zeus should be taken from the entire Roman world. This was the first instance that took place while
Quirinius was governor of Syria,
and everyone went to their own town to rest. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and his pregnant child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no rest made available for them. And there she took his son out of the house, hereby keeping watch over the flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to him, do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Amen. You may be seated in the household of the Lord. And again this morning, we're going to talk about the ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice. The ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice. This morning we're going to talk about a sovereign census. We're going to talk about a sovereign city. We're going to talk about a sovereign creation and a sovereign citation.
All right.
Sovereignty simply meaning God putting people in the right place at the right time to accomplish His will. We want Christians to know this morning that Christians should tell the world about Jesus the ultimate sacrifice. Christians should tell the world about Jesus the ultimate sacrifice. This morning we come to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we as a church are the only ones who can really celebrate, because in the world it just has become a holiday.
Well,
but we as a church raise the banner of Jesus Christ, and we want the world to know that Jesus is the reason, the only reason for Christmas.
All right.
And right now in the text we learn some of the things that were going on in the text, that God allowed things to happen a certain way so that he could accomplish his will.
Yeah.
And the first thing we look at in the text today is we look at a sovereign census. Well, the Bible says in those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census be taken of the entire Roman world. And on the face of this text, it just looks like regular governmental activity. But this was not just a regular governmental activity, a census, into which we just finished a census here in the United States. But this census was a census that would be used to accomplish God's will. That's why we call it a sovereign census. Right here today, we have somebody under a sovereign census. You don't know, but God has worked things out this morning for you to be in this place at this time. A sovereign census in which we have a program, a church program that would normally start at 11, but this morning it started at 10, a sovereign census. And God has put you in the right place at the right time to accomplish his will. In the text, if you study some census, we see that some census don't have to be a sovereign census. Some census are just secular census. In 1 Chronicles chapter 21, verses 1 through 2, we see that Satan rose against Israel and incited David against a census to take a census of Israel.
That's right.
And you better be careful, people of God, what causes you to rise up against what God is doing in his plans. You see, David, he wanted to do it, but Satan rose up in him.
Come on.
And Satan rose up in against him, and was trying to get him to do something that God didn't want to be done. And you better be careful when you rise up, because when you rise up, it may not be the Lord that's moving on your behalf. It may be the devil rising up in you.
Come on.
David was a man of God, but David was used by the devil because he allowed Satan to rise up against in him.
Come on.
He allowed the devil to move in his flesh. And dear people of God, don't allow the devil to rise up in your flesh.
Amen.
Because you can be used to try to stop the program of God. You can be used. And any of us at any time can get in the flesh, and the devil can try to speak through us, regardless of if we're David. David described as a man after God's own heart, but David got tripped up in the flesh many times. Hello, somebody. So let's not follow the bad example of David, but let us really look and see what God is doing. And in this test, this was a sovereign census. God had worked everything out together for his good. Hello, somebody. We're talking about a sovereign census. And in this sovereign census, it was taken in a sovereign city. For the text says, Joseph. Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to Bethlehem, the town of David. So it was a sovereign census, and this sovereign census was done, oh, to put them in a sovereign city, in a sovereign city in Bethlehem. And there's somebody here today, you're in a sovereign city right now. Oh, you're in a sovereign church because God worked it out for you to be here this morning in this sovereign church, named after the sovereign city. Oh, Bethlehem means house of bread. And in this house of bread, God can knows that your hunger, knows that you're thirsting after the things of God. And he has put you in this place at this time to accomplish his will. Say to your neighbor, neighbor,
you're in
a sovereign place. Again, sovereignty means God putting you in the right place at the right time to accomplish his will. And this is what God had done, because there was a prophecy in Micah chapter 5. And this prophecy told about a Savior that would be born in a city called Bethlehem. And there was only one problem in the text, is that, oh, it says in verse 4, so Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth. Joseph was in Nazareth.
All right.
And Nazareth, was a place that was not mentioned in the prophecy. The prophecy said that a Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. And Nazareth was about 70 miles away from Bethlehem. About as far as here, about as far as Ardmore is to Moore, 70 miles away. So in order for God's word to come true, in order for God's word to be right, in order for this prophecy to happen, God moved in the heart of a king to give a census. And this was a sovereign census. And that sovereign census led to this sovereign city. Are you in the right place at the right time to accomplish God's will? Hello, somebody. Are you, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, are you in the right place at the right time to get to know him? Prayerfully, you are in the right place at the right time to get to know him. And probably this is not just another church service, but this is a service to where you come right into the face of God.
All right,
hello, somebody. Talking about that sovereign census that led to a sovereign city so that a sovereign creation could happen. For it says that while they were there, the time came for the birth, for a baby to be born.
Right.
And they gave birth to her firstborn, a son. And she wrapped him in, the King James says, swaddling clothing. And that needs to be there, swaddling clothing. And placed him in a manger.
Right. Well.
And that night, the innkeeper didn't know what was really going on, and many people in our day and time didn't really know what was going on in the birth of Jesus Christ. But we have come here today to let you know what John 3:16 says. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. And that's what John 3:16 has to say. And that's what the sovereign creation was that night. That God's only Son was born in a manger. Hello, somebody.
Come on.
Humble beginnings. Humble beginnings for someone who had God in him. The sovereign census led to a sovereign city that led to a sovereign creation.
All right.
And the sovereign creation was a creation for the whole world to that he gave you the greatest gift that you could ever have. God loves you so much. Some listening at the sound of my voice, you may have never known your daddy. You may have never known your mother. You may have never known your family. You may be a giveaway, or maybe you was born out of wedlock, or you had so many stripes against you going up and coming up. Somebody listening at the sound of my voice could have been thinking about suicide during this time that so many people are happy. Oh, but God has sent me here today to let you know to reach out in the midst of your loneliness, to reach out in the midst of you feeling despair and feeling forgotten, to remind you, even some who've accepted Christ, to remind you that Jesus died for you and you alone. Somebody ought to give God a hand and have a praise up in here, up in here. For the true gift of Christmas. Oh, and you don't have to go to a tree to get this gift. Oh, you got to go to a cross to get this gift. And this gift is not wrapped up in beautiful wrapping paper, but this gift was wrapped up in a body that was scorned, that was mocked, that was beaten. Oh, this gift, had blood on it. It had that blood on it for you. Say to your neighbor, neighbor. God loves you.
God loves you
that much.
That much.
God loves you.
Yeah.
That much.
Thank you, Lord.
And He wants you to know today.
Yes, sir.
He wants you to know today. And you are the reason for the season.
Man.
Because He died for you. This gift has your name on it.
Well, that's good, man.
This gift has your name on it. But there was a sovereign creation that took place, and not only was there a sovereign creation that night, but there was a sovereign citation.
Right.
Because this was the ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice. For it didn't say that He was just born that night, but it says that He was wrapped in swaddling clothes. That means that child was wrapped up in dead man's clothes.
Come on.
Because He was born to die. The ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice. And when it said in verse 12, this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. Lying in a manger, this would be a sign for you. Oh, because most children are not wrapped up in dead men's clothes. Most children have the best kind of clothes. Oh, but this child was born.
Yeah.
To die!
My.
I said this child.
This child.
Was born to die. The ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice.
Yes.
The ultimate birth.
Well.
For the ultimate sacrifice. 1 Corinthians 15, 3 through 4 says, "For I have received, or for what I received, I pass on to you as of first importance."
All right.
"That Jesus died for our sins."
Thank you, Lord.
"According
to the
scripture."
Yes, sir.
"Jesus died for our sins according to the scripture."
Amen.
"And He was buried, and that He was raised on the third day according to the scripture." It's all right to give God a hand clap of praise because He was. Ultimate birth for the ultimate sacrifice. He would die for our sins. He would die for our sins. I said He would die For our sins be buried and raised again on the third day according to the scripture.
Yes, Lord.
The ultimate sacrifice.
Yes, Lord.
The ultimate sacrifice. We want you to know before you leave this place, if you do not know Jesus, that this is a sovereign moment in time. God has set you up to come to know Him. I said, God has set you up to come to know Him. And if you don't know Him and the pardoning of your sins, all eyes closed and heads bowed, we want you.
We don't need another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.